This is the Central Arctic, the Kara Sea, one of the most forbidding places on our planet. Quite recently, these blocks of ice, these fields of snow, and multitude of islands stretching from the northern borders of the Soviet Union to the North Pole itself were proudly named the Arctic possession of the USSR. These islands are not to be found in any ordinary geographic map. They served as aerodromes for strategic bombers to take off and to land. Nuclear weapons were tested here, and missiles were launched from local launch pads. One can find the traces of the past military splendor on these desert clumps of land. Like sunken ships, on them lingers the memory of those who served here. In April 2001, an unusual expedition left Norilsk for the lost islands of the Central Arctic, the participants of which were ham radio operators well known in Russia and abroad, in order to broadcast from this frozen edge of the world. We meet in downtown Norilsk, near the headquarters of the Norilsk Mining Company. We are facing a two-week stay in a tent with temperature inside equal to that outside and are hoping for as many broadcasts with the outer world as possible. The proximity of Arctic can already be left. In the middle of April, the temperature is minus 38 Celsius, with the wind chill. Despite the frost, many people have come to the company headquarters. A memorial plaque is being opened today dedicated to the centenary of Avrami Zavinyagin, a name known to everyone in Norilsk. Both the city of Norilsk and the mining company, one of the largest world producers of nickel, copper, cobalt and platinum, owe Zavinyagin their creation and development. Now, the Norilsk Nickel Mining Company counts for one-fifth of the world's output of nickel, more than one-half of palladium production, one-fourth of platinum, one-fifth of rhodium, and an essential share of cobalt's output. It so happened that we came to Norilsk at Easter. Therefore, we could not but attend the Easter service in church. Not many of us go to church regularly, but what lies in store for us somehow makes us think about our dependence upon the mercy of God even now, in the 21st century. Will the radio signal reach through? The weathermen keep talking about the sun's intense activity and magnetic storms. Will our equipment survive the perils of the north? How reliable is our generator set? How will our meetings with polar bears turn out? And a lot more. None of us is chance visitor on board this plane. Vladimir Chukov, skied from Russia to Canada via the North Pole. Victoria Karukina is the main organizer and the spirit of the expedition. In 1995, she discovered Ruski Island of the Northern Shelled Archipelago for the world of radio enthusiasts. Pavel Svetkov is the head of the famous Krasnoyarsk radio station RK0AXX, a very experienced radio man. Valery Sushkov traveled in the Antarctic in 1999. Yuri Zaruba reached the South Pole in the year 2000. This is going to be his 63rd radio expedition. Alexander Sukharev and Andrei Moiseev broadcast from Ruski Island together with Victoria, Yuri and Valery, an event that attracted the whole world's attention. All the others are also experienced adventure seekers. We are not well acquainted yet, but people in the Arctic open up to each other quickly. Dixon was the name of a Norwegian merchant who sponsored an expedition which discovered this island 200 years ago. Until now, Dixon has been the headquarters of the State Meteorological Service, a transit base for many scientific expeditions, the headquarters of the Border Guards and Anti-Aircraft Force. North America is nearby, across the pole. Now the island's life has slowed down. The troops have been withdrawn, research programs closed. In the recent years, the island's population has reduced tenfold. Some people leave for the continent, while the other become voluntary hermits, having accepted the insular mentality and the magnificent calmness of the surrounding nature as part of their fate. But today, the call signs coming from Dixon are in the focus of the world's attention. The expedition Lost Islands is on the air.
R1, щука, щука, Коля, привет, дружище. 5-9, пятерка, девятка, QSL. Да, понял, Саш. Значит, мы завтра планируем в 11 по local time вылетать на остров Средний.
Backed in the helicopter, like herrings in a barrel, we're leaving Dixon, the last outpost of civilization. We are flying north. Ahead of us are only polar stations, frontier posts and inhabited islands. Boundless space called the Central Arctic. Eclipse Bay, refueling. While the pilots are busy with the helicopter, Sukharev and Tsvetkov are setting a radio station right on the snow. We are in a hurry to inform the world that we are approaching the main goal of our expedition, Ushakova Island. However, we hear only wheezing and hissing on their ear. No connection. A magnetic storm is to blame, caused by an unprecedented solar activity. Here in high latitudes, its effect is especially noticeable. If we hear the same on Ushakova Island tonight, the expedition, which have been nurturing for 6 years, will turn out to be a disaster. This is Srednyi Island, a narrow stony strip of land, 4 kilometers by 800 meters, a frontier post. Somewhere here Russia ends, although no one knows exactly where. Border guards are examining our documents and show where a barrel with diesel fuel for our genset can be taken. The helicopter becomes even more packed.
Нет, мы не едем, мы летим.
This is our last flight to the island, which has been a dream of radio enthusiasts for decades. It all started on September the 1st, 1935, when Sutko Icebreaker approached an unknown island to be named after Georgi Ushakov, the head of the first Soviet high-latitude expedition. In different time, different polar stations were opened and closed on the island. But no radio man has ever sent signals from this island. Ushakova Island is the last blank spot on the radio map of Central Arctic. If we are lucky, we will soon send its precise radio coordinates to the world. We do not know what to expect. We are to test ourselves and our electronic equipment in extreme conditions, as well as to find out the possibility of radio signals going from the northern part of the Kara Sea to the other parts of the Earth. The icy top of an ancient mountain, towering over the sea at the height of 250 meters, will become our home for 8 days. During this time, we are planning to have about 10,000 radio sessions. We We are making a camp and setting radio antennas next to the snow-drifted houses of the polar station, while Europe, Africa, Australia, and two Americas are already searching for us on the air, setting their radio stations to our frequencies. Those people are presidents, sovereigns, retired officers, school children, and certainly our friends. So we have to hurry. The first communication was established when some of our things were still outside the tent.
Первое кинесо, остров Ушакова, Валерий, а это не Иван. Я радио Иван 0, Борис, остров Ушакова, кинесо. А это не Иван, номер не выдан, первое кинесо, кинесо. Еще раз.
Вайгач! Слушай, какой символизм! Символично, совершенно! Остров Вайгач! Первая связь между островами!
Вот и остров Вайгач, Европа 086. Спасибо большое! Первая связь с Айотой. Мы рады приветствуем вас от нашего коллектива. Будьте здоровы, до встречи. Один Павел, Анна, Ольга, дробь Павел. Я радио Иван 0, Борис, остров Ушакова, Айота, Иван. Пока.
УА-3, Борис Михаил, Борис Мария.
УА-3, Борис Мария, 5-9.
Окей, вам тоже пятерка, девятка, 5-9.
Спасибо, УА-3, Борис Мария, в моем журнале. Ромео, Италы, Зиро, Браво. Ушаков, Айланд, QRZ, 510 KC up, QRZ.
That night, we got connected with Roger Ballister from London, host of the Islands on Air program. After a short conversation, he assigned the number Asia 156 to the newly radio-discovered Ushakov Island. There are no longer white spots on the radio map of Central Arctic. Step by step, we make the island our temporary home. We fix the tent and see the sights. The work on the air does not stop for a minute, day or night, although night is a relative term here. The sun, without setting, travels around in a circle, blinding our eyes. It is polar day in the Arctic. Constant cold and being stuck at the radio station deprive us of precious body heat. Warm clothes do not help. Only hot tea and rich food make us feel warmer.
Температура где-то минус 25-30 градусов мороза и ветер порывистый, где-то 10-15 метров в секунду. Такие порывы ветров. И погода меняется довольно быстро. То ветер, то пурга, то такая, ну, знаешь, ну, в общем, все быстро как-то меняется здесь. Поэтому, ну, в общем, все нормально. У нас настроение бодрое, начали активно работу в эфире, так что все нормально.
Here is a preserved polar station. The last man left it over a decade ago, while the master, this is the nickname of the polar bear in the north, was here quite recently, judging by the paw prints. So we have to be on the alert. This little house used to be inhabited by people. They would get outside only in pairs, only to check the instrument readings. The house was more than just a dwelling for them. It saved their lives in the extreme conditions of the far north. This is an amazing find. Vladimir Chukov finds his own picture on the cover of one of the issues of Around the World magazine.
Ah, подожди, а может быть даже этот переход был? Я писал как с большим опозданием. Скорее всего здесь была статья по карскому морю.
We continue exploring the house, which is like a deserty spaceship, thanking fate for the opportunity to touch the relics of our polar history.
20 апреля 1989 года. Приборы, оборудование исправно. Оружие 8, патронов в комплекте, что ли? В наличии. Я расписался.
We have decided to set our second radio station in one of the rooms of the icy house. After 10 years of silence, these worlds will hear again the dots and dashes of the Morse code. Our predecessors, though, could only dream of having the equipment we use now. They could get connected only with the neighboring islands. We talk with the whole world.
Я бегу, потому что из меня уже сосулька. Холодно. Все, я побежал. Сейчас скажу, что замерз и больше не могу.
DJ 9 ZB, thanks, 5 and 9.
Roger, you're also 5 and 9, добрый вечер.
Thank you, Romeo, Italy 0 Bravo. Sugar 50, Oscar, 59.
59, Oscar, thank you.
Sugar 5-0, Oscar, right now, is it right?
Roger.
Thank you, Romeo, Italy 0 Bravo.
Hotel Alpha 8, Kilo Washington Ocean.
Hotel Alpha 8, Kilo Whiskey Ocean, you 5 and 9.
Thank you very much, the same 5-9, good luck.
Thank you, QRZ. Romeo, Italy 0 Bravo, QRZ.
And who should appear but the master, quite near the camp? Leonid Safonov, the expedition's mechanic, takes its picture almost face to face, while Victoria and Slava Gosudarev, an experienced polar explorer, are trying to scare the bear off with their screams and sounds of shooting. This time we are lucky. We notice the bear on time. In spring, the polar bears go hungry for several months and are not very choosy in their eating habits. The constant hidden hazard becomes apparent this time. Tonight is remarkable. With absolute stillness and three suns overhanging the camp in the low sky. Captivated by sight, we are admiring this magnificent spectacle without suspecting what would follow soon. A hurricane wind threatens to tear our tent off. It is beaten with such force that it is flutters and flaps like a flag in the wind, while its walls and roof sag under the weight of the snow blown on them by the blizzard.
The island is Ushakova Island, I spell. United Sierra, Hotel America, Kilo Ocean, Victoria America, Ushakova Island, the last island in the Central Arctic. Asia 156, are you the reference? Asia 156. QSL information via Romeo Whiskey 3, Guatemala Whiskey, QSL.
We are worried about our antennas, bent like arcs, and the genset. Once it crashes, it will be impossible to restart it. However, we do not lose spirit. All the more so as in such weather radio waves are transmitted much better than usual.
Thank you very much.
Delta, you're 5-9, over.
Kilo India 4 Alpha Delta, QSL, you're 59 from Romeo Italy Zero Bravo. This is Asia 156. Romeo Italy Zero Bravo, 5KCF.
Whiskey 4, Foxtrot, Canada.
Whiskey 4, Fox Charlie, 59.
Roger, Alpha 59.
Romeo Italy Zero Bravo, Romeo Italy Zero Bravo. Romeo Italy Zero Bravo, Romeo Italy Zero Bravo. Easy 156, QRZ. Народ, вы где?
Norway 2, America Uniform.
November 2, America United, thank you for the calling. 59, good signal, over. And 2AU, November 2, Alpha United, 59, over. QSL, thank you from Romeo Italy Zero Bravo. Romeo Italy Zero Bravo, 5KC up.
Whiskey 3, Sugar India, Sierra India, Sugar India.
Oh my god, the booming signal, W3 Sierra India, U59 plus, QSL.
Roger, Roger, the 59 plus, U59 also, my signal here on the East Coast this evening. Many thanks for Asia 156, that's a new one for me. Are you okay for QSL via your home call? Romeo India Zero Bravo, is that Roger?
Negative. My home call is Romeo Zulu 9 Ocean Ocean, name is Alex. And QSL information via Romeo Whiskey 3 Guatemala Whiskey. Romeo Whiskey 3 Germany Whiskey, QSL.
Romeo 3, Alex, many thanks.
Thank you. Romeo Italy Zero Bravo, 5KTF. 156, here is it. Romeo Italy Zero Bravo. Romeo Italy Zero Bravo, Asia 156.
The blizzard stops as suddenly as it started. Complete calm sets in. Our camp is almost intact. Only our tent has a snow drift nearly up to the roof. We continue working on the air, where our expedition has aroused genuine excitement. Our families and friends are certainly most interested.
Yuri, как вы там себя чувствуете? Как там не замерзли прием?
Конечно, самая главная борьба – это здесь за живучесть, борьба с холодом. Но вот заодно была еще и борьба с медведями. Было небольшое, так сказать, посещение станции, но мы успешно отразили, и медведь ушел в сторону Карского моря. Вторая рабочая позиция работает одновременно с первой на другом диапазоне – на 18 и на 21 МГц. Все участники экспедиции чувствуют себя хорошо. Мы провели уже около 8 тысяч радиосвязей. Присвоен учетный номер последнему белому радиопятну острову Ушакова в северной части Карского моря Азия-156. Как принято в Новосибирске, радио Василий 9, Ольга Василий Дмитрий. Здесь радио Иван 0 Борис. Прием, прием.
0 Борис и радио Василий 9, Ольга Василий Дима. Юрий, рад слышать. Принимаю среднее, но уверенно. 5-9, Андрей в Новосибирске.
Скажи, пожалуйста, как там погода у вас? У нас сегодня где-то плюс 15 градусов в Красноярске. Как там у вас?
Понятно. Ну, у нас прямая противоположность где-то минус 20, минус 25.
25.04. 25.04. Планируется. Планируется. Вылететь. Вылететь. На остров уединения.
We are leaving Ushakov Island, 2 days ahead of schedule. Signal transmission is very good. All the magnetic storms stopped and we are heard even in the Antarctic. 10,000 communications we plan to register in our logs are there before 8 days previously planned. On the sixth day, we already have 13,000 of them. We use the 2 days' winnings to work on the Uyedinenye Island, Domashny Island. We have landed here to stand near the grave of Georgi Ushakov, whose last will was to be buried here. Where in 1932 he put up a small house and from where he rode in a dog sled around the archipelago, having photographed and described everything. Next to Ushakov's grave, those are buried who spent their lives in the Arctic and who did not want to part with it, even after death.
This is Romeo Sierra Zero Bravo. The expedition to 3D Island, Romeo Sierra Zero Bravo. Iota is Asia 042. Iota Asia 042. Sydney Island, Polar Radio Expedition, the Lost
Island. We are on Sredny Island now, enjoying the long-awaited bath and a sleepover in a warm border outpost.
Romeo Washington 3 Golf Whiskey. Чилсельва, Ромео Уэски, Трой Голф Уэски. Здесь полярная кинорадиоэкспедиция, затерянные острова, Китэйчи, архипелаг, Северная Земля, остров Средний. Я радио Сергей 0 Борис, меня зовут Валерий, Чилсель через Роман Василий, 3 Галина Василий.
We installed the transceiver right in the outpost's radio cabin, intending to spend the night communicating on a short wavelength. The world radio community, excited by our signals from Ushakova Island, has decided to trace down every movement we make. Those who could not get a place near the transceiver are getting ready for a sleep in the outpost gym. Tomorrow we will have a difficult day. We will fly to Uyedinenye Island, make a camp there, set antennas, and tell the world about another lost island. We are visiting a museum, a real museum arranged by St. Petersburg enthusiasts in the house of Ushakov Urvantsev expedition. Moved here from Domashny Island, a couple of kilometers from here.
Последнее крупнейшее географическое открытие сделано на нашей планете уже в начале этого века. Вот. И его открытие было настолько же неожиданным, насколько и неотвратимым. В 13-14 году по решению русского правительства была направлена экспедиция гидрографическая в районы полярных морей. Вот, и 1 сентября по новому стилю ледокольные пароходы Таймырова и Гач подошли к неведомой ранней земле. Эти суда были специально построены.
This is a museum of not only past, but also present Arctic history. So the exhibits mostly arrive from the abandoned polar stations, which are on almost every island. We are listening to stories about the first polar expedition, which landed here 70 years ago, with primitive equipment and imperfect instruments, about long winter seasons and tiresome trips from island to island. And we are thinking about the main feature of the Arctic. During these decades, nothing has actually changed. It still attracts adventurers like a magnet. Below us, once again, is a desert of ice. We observe the hummocky ice fields, hoping to see polar bears again, traveling around the endless ice fields in search of food. Soon the helicopter will start rising. We are flying to Uyedinenye Island, where there is a preserved polar meteorological station, which marks perhaps one of the saddest pages in the polar history books. The helicopter lands in the center of a large settlement. Unlike Ushakov Island, with its couple of miserable huts, it has at least a dozen of houses of different sizes. There are beacons established on the hills on both sides of the island. It looks like the sea is deep enough near the shore, which allowed ships to come near. There is no one. Only bear tracks.
Что, документы, картины?
Ну, конечно,
видимо, такое чувство, что люди хотели вернуться.
In 1996, the supply of fuel at the station ran out. The explorers bombarded the authorities with telegrams. The authorities asked them to wait and hold, promising to send everything they needed. But on November 26, a helicopter landed all of a sudden. The explorers learned that there would be no fuel and that they should board the helicopter with only the most important load, as there would be no other aircraft. Sergei Politaev, the pilot of our helicopter, took the people from the station. How did they feel? Perhaps the same as seamen looking at their sinking ship. Widineni Island, the local Titanic. So far, this is the last preserved Central Arctic station. Disaster strikes again. Hurrying to unload, to choose a place to work on the air. We forgot to start our wonderful Japanese 6-kilowatt diesel generator set. And it, of course, did not take kindly to being ignored. For 6 hours now, it has not been responding to our attempts to get its attention. The silence is ominous. The sound of a working generator has become natural for us during the recent days, and now its silence hurts our ears. Leonid Safonov, our close-lipped mechanic, brings the genset back to life only after 12 hours. The genset first begins to sneeze and cough, then it starts working to supply us with our precious first kilowatts.
Romeo United Zero Bravo, Romeo United Zero Bravo, Romeo Uniform Zero Bravo, Asia 057, QRZ. Привет, Сереж, первое КСО с тобой, РА-3 РГКЮ, спасибо, 5-9, остров уединения, Азия 057, QSL через УА-9, Ольга Борисанна.
Communication is conducted from 2 rooms in the radio station house. Now we understand the advantages of a thin tent before deep frozen walls and ceiling. In the tent, it is just cold. In the abandoned house, it is cold and wet. The conditions are perfect for a radio man to feel fully what he has read about in the numerous books about the polar explorers. Biting cold, the semi-darkness of a room lit by a table lamp, and cabling with a telegraph key and Morse code.
Вот это надо снимать! Знаменитый VK9 Нэнси Сьерра, Джим Смит.
Мы на уединение живем в брошенной полярной станции. Живем в брошенной полярной станции. Все нормально, не грустите. Скоро будем дома.
Окей, Sierra Papa 8, America, Japan Kilo, 5-9. Окей, Sierra Papa 8, America, Japan Kilo, thanks. У1 Анна Николаевна, спасибо, 5-9. Спасибо, удачи. Romeo United Zero Bravo, listening 520 up, QRZ.
This is all that is left from the busy station with lots of equipment, workshops, and even a movie room. An automatic polar station, working from a nuclear battery and transmitting data about the air temperature the speed and direction of wind to the artificial satellite. Everything else is just abandoned, so the term preserved can be applied only to a small part of the station, a supply of canned squash in their storehouse.
Number 5, Delta, something 59, Italy, November.
We decide to warm up our radio cabin. We have everything necessary for it. A working transceiver and an amplifier emit enough heat. The genset's capacity is more than sufficient, and there are a couple or more electric heaters in each building on the island. Now we can work in the cabin without a down coat and a hat on. The radio operators take shifts near the radio stations. During the 3 days of work, 10,000 communications have been made, some of them unforgettable.
Ректори Анна Ольга Елена, дроп Анна Мария. Я Роман Ульяна 0 Борис.
Роман Ульяна 0 Борис. Роман 23, Анна Ольга Елена, дроп Анна Мария. Здесь самолет Boeing 737-700.
Окей, пожалуйста, ваше имя.
Имя Юрий, рапорт 59 в Пресаде. Очень громко принимаю. Пожалуйста, мне рапорт
принимаю. Окей, Юрий, Киосов. Я также 59 плюс 20, наверное, принимаю. Очень громкий, стабильный, хороший сигнал на приеме.
Понятно, но текущая позиция сейчас в районе Задонска. Задонска, это Воронежская область, время.
Окей, ясно, Киосов. Но здесь какие условия у нас? Еще стоит хорошая зима, хотя уже полярный день, круглый день светит солнце. Но в районе 20-25 градусов мороз. Сегодня солнечный тихий день, так что очень приятно было походить, посмотреть на остров, на полярную станцию. На привет.
Привет, Павел. Ну, прекрасно. Ну, оглушительно вас принимаю. Вообще просто отменное качество сигнала. Ну, здесь аппарат авиационной фирмы Коллинз, и антенна наклеена на вертикальном оперении. И все это дело автоматически антенной сюда настраивается. Здесь очень примитивная настройка. Идет с шагом 1 кГц. Вот. И два положения верхней боковой амплитуды модуляции. Очень примитивный трансивер, но это чисто такое авиационное. Юрий 0, Борис, РФ3, Анна, Ольга, Елена, друг Антон Мария.
Окей, Киосел Юрий. Ну, спасибо за Киосел, за интересную информацию. Вот уже мы работали с кораблями, сейчас вот с самолетом. Очень приятно слышать вас. Ну, хорошее очень прохождение, удивительно даже. Не надеялись на такое прохождение в эти дни. Практически каждый день открыты все диапазоны. Работаем практически на всех верхних. Только не ходили на нижние диапазоны, так как нет прохождения, а здесь полярный день. Но попробуем, может что-нибудь получится. РФ3 Анна Ольга Елена, дроп Анна Мария. Я радио Ульяна 0 Борис, остров Уединения. 73, до свидания.
До свидания, Павел, 73. Здесь Роман, Сактри, Анна, Ольга, Елена.
Так, ну и последний вопрос. Это дети мои, как там поживают? Помнят ли меня или забыли уже на приеме?
Все тихо, все спокойно. Я думаю, что все нормально.
Начни с детей, позвони, я бы подождала, хорошо?
Хорошо, завтра, потому что сегодня это уже без 15:02 ночи.
Да? А я думала, что в день.
Сейчас уже глубокая ночь.
Поздравление по экспедиции белорусской.
The Belarusian expedition are greeting us. They are riding in their unusual cars somewhere in Taimur. We met them in the Antarctic, where we provided radio communication for an expedition bound for the South Pole. It looks as though the travel bug hasn't only caught us.
Okay, спасибо, Юрий. Всего доброго еще раз. До свидания. Пока.
The plans we made at home have been exceeded. 10,000 communications within 3 days. It is time to leave. On the way home, we will land on Isachenko Island, Sergei Kirov Archipelago, for a couple of hours. There is another abandoned polar station here.
But very, very shortly operation, maybe 3, 4, maximum 5 hours. 28 April, from 02 Greenwich Equator. Please looking for our expedition. Now this is already
United. Поподробнее ничего не скажет. Были на месте там или нет, как это все вообще?
RK0AXX has been burnt. The Krasnoyarsk radio enthusiasts called Pavel Cvetkov, and now we see tears in his eyes. RK0AXX was a cooperative radio station in the village of Tvorogovor, a suburb of Krasnoyarsk. It was built in the late 70s. It was a two-storied big building with a dozen radio masts on a hill. From the first days of his existence, Pavel worked there as the technical director, building everything with his own hands. Then he became the station's director. That was the best Russian radio station, known to the whole radio world as RK0AXX. It got burned right down to its foundation. Pavel is shivering. We are standing around him, unable to do anything to alleviate his sufferings. We have a feeling that a dear one has died. Radio brings not only good news.
Со связью нормально, пока все нормально. Вот сейчас антенну специально на вас поставили, слышно хорошо.
На вас тоже хорошо слышно. На связи сколько проверили?
Так, отсюда, наверное, 1007-8 уже.
О, хорошо. Ну ладно, до завтра.
Нет, даже попросить, чтобы вы не
соседили. Погода солнечная, ветра почти нет. Ну такое постоянное, дует, порывов нет. Солнечная, хорошая погода.
Ну, здесь также, где-то в районе 25 градусов тоже. Ну, до завтра ждите, 8:30 утра будем у вас.
Maybe 28 April, from 02 Greenwich, from 02 Greenwich time, we plan very, very shortly operation in Sergei Kirova Islands. On Sergei Kirova Islands, Alpha Sierra 050. But very, very shortly operation, maybe 3 or maximum 5 hours. 28 April, from 02 Greenwich and Plate. Please looking for our expedition.
Мы его, я лично его возил.
А почему?
Ну, топливо кончается. Топливо. Все упирается в топливо.
The helicopter crew commander Sergei Politaev has been in the Arctic for 18 years. His biography is full of stories which could be good for a dozen of movies. He evacuated the station too. Politaev has been offered work on the continent many times. They offered him good money. Pilots like him are worth millions. The commander is reserved, but he is looking around as if he wants to imprint everything in his memory. Our flight is Politaev's last mission here. There is no work here for him anymore. We have 2 hours at our disposal, so we make our temporary camp very fast. The diesel generator is already working. We have learned the lesson of Rodinenia Island. After about 20 minutes, Valery Sushkov sends the call promised the day before.
Islands of Kirova, Asia 050, QSL manager, United Alpha 9, Oscar Bravo Alpha, from Romania, United 0 Bravo, stroke portable, Lishnik 5 to 20 up, Lishnik 5, 20 up, Lishnik 5, 20 up, radio United 0 Bravo, stroke portable, here is it.
Sugar Papa 8, Alpha Juliet,
Sugar Papa 8, Alpha Juliet, Kilo, 5 and 9. Sugar Papa 8, Alpha Juliet, Kilo, 5 and 9.
Sugar Papa 8, America, Juliet, Kilo, 1 для меня.
Sugar Papa 8, America, Japan, Kilo, 5 and 9. Thank you. А3, Галина, знак, 5-9. Спасибо. Romania, United, 0, Bravo, stock portable, Asia, 0, 5, 0, Lishnik, 5, 20, up. Here is it. У один Ольга Леонид Мария 5-9.
Спасибо,
тоже
5-9.
Delta Fox 2 November Sugar 5-9.
Delta 5-9.
Thank you. РВ4 Харитон Василий Валера привет 5-9. Валера 5-9. РВ4 ХВ
5-9.
Thank you. Romeo United 0 Bravo Stroke Portable Asia 050 Kirova Islands QRZ Listening 520 up QRZ.
The air is jammed. Valery hears fragments of calls in this noise and is able to respond in different languages. It is a mystery how he can develop such a speed. Every 12 seconds a new record appears in the log. And now Sushkov is bringing another report. He makes no unnecessary movements. Every cell of his brain is working under extreme pressure. He does not notice frost, wind, exhaustion. There is nothing except this wheezing and hissing. Here they are, the most desired moments in the life of any ham radio operator.
Delta Fox 2, November Sierra 5-9.
Специально нас ждали, то есть в Европе получается 5 часов утра. Народ не спит, народ был извещен. 40 минут. И все понимают, что такой шанс бывает. Ну, если не раз в жизни, то очень.
Italy Kilo 8, Oscar Zulu Zulu, thank you. Игорь Краткий, Ольга, 5-9. Проход вообще полностью ехался. Листья поднялось.
Что, да ну, так не бывает.
Бывает, иди послушай. Все, вообще.
Все, сворачиваться надо, да, если мы не погоду портим.
Вообще ничего. Резко обрубился проход, и вообще сейчас ничего нет. Средств связи проведена. Резко проход обрубился и все. Представляешь? То же самое было на Ушакове. То же самое. Вот такой солнце.
The weather is changes for the worse. It is snowing. The wind has blown a lot of snow from somewhere. We have decided to take off. If in 5 or 10 minutes transmission is not restored. This lack of passage has finally reached us. At the very end of our trip. There is nothing we can do about it. We have already been very lucky. The minute hand of the watch kills our last hope. Alexander Sukarev is sitting near the transceiver. He continues to send the calls of Isachenko Island onto the air. Either from desperation or following special radio intuition. And suddenly someone switches the air for us back again. Again, we are called in all languages, and again, we hear calls of the island bearing a strange Russian name. While Victoria, Zaruba and Sushkov are holding a powwow, first among themselves and then with Politaev. As we find out in the helicopter, we are going to land on yet another island. Valery is continuing the calls recorded on Isachenko Island. There are 500 of them. 500 during 2 hours. We have not replied to all. And now we are facing a landing on a Kravkova Island, Mona Archipelago. This is as unexpected for us as it is for those waiting for the new calls of our expedition. The station on Krafkover Island was closed down in 1971. It is quite small, a house with a bacon on top and a bathhouse. We have very little time, so we put the station right in the bathhouse. Probably no one's ever done that before. To the list of our expedition's achievements, we now add radio communication from a bathhouse.
CQ-20, radio Sierra Zero Bravo, stroke portable. Romeo Sierra Zero Bravo, stroke portable. Alpha Sierra 068. Alpha Sierra 068, Mona Island, like Mike Oscar November Alpha Island. This is radio Sierra Zero Bravo, stroke portable. Listening 510 up, QRZ. Center Gully, 59. One only ACG, vlog, one only Y, 59. Спасибо, 59. Alpha Charlie, 59. RV9, Анна Боря, 59. Спасибо, Alpha Charlie, 59. Роман Жук, 1, Анна Центр, спасибо. Romeo Sierra Zero Bravo Stroke Portable. Iota Asia 068, Listening 510 up, QRZ. 1-0, Анна Центр, Галя, 59. RV3, Тамара, 59. У3, Галина, знак, 59. Oscar November 5, Japan Yankee 59. Roger 5-9. 2-4, Сергей, Костя, Василий, 5-9. Спасибо, радио Ульяна 3, радио Киловатт, 5-9. Thank you, Romeo, Sierra Zero, Bravo, Stock Portable, QRZ up.
It becomes hotter. We continue getting calls from different latitudes, but it seems we have to go. The helicopter has to be in Dixon on time. Besides, 370 communications within 2 hours from the island, which has been silent for 30 years, is not so bad at all. Especially when we think that in the near future, maybe even for decades, no one will return here.
Азия 068 сделали. На островах Мона. Роман Сергей 0 болезнь. Друг погиб. Почти 400 связей сделали. За неполных 2 часа.
Все классно. Такого в мире еще не было. И мы это сделали. И еще повторим. Все вместе.
Что, я вас всех поздравляю с тем, что вы осуществили такую веерную экспедицию по островам Арктики, немножечко клепнули вот эту арктическую сухость.
Арктического кайфа. Да?
Экзотики. И все.
Юра.
Все закончилось?
Юра!
Нашей экспедиции. Нам очень было радостно с вами летать. Выполнили такую большую программу. Экипаж дарит вам большую радиолампу Арктики. Я думаю, с ней вы еще не раз вернетесь к нам.
5 баллов!
Музей Института Арктики и Антарктики.
Это кубок своеобразный. Это своеобразный кубок.
А точно. Ну так может мы на фоне кубка хоть фотографию на мой фотоаппарат.
The expedition is over. We have done what no one has done before. We have discovered a new island for the radio world, the most inaccessible and therefore the most desirable island. We got tired of cold and are missing our loved ones. We have tested each other's reliability and have gained new friends. Not only have we traveled around the abandoned polar stations, we have traveled back in time, where time stopped at the moment when the island was deserted by the last of its inhabitants. If that's the case, our expedition has started time again. Now, thousands of people pronounce these strange Russian names in different languages. Ushakova, Sredny, Isachenko, Uyedinenia, Kravkova. Now, these are not lost islands. Now, these islands are on the air.